All right, we have Ohio State student athletes Keita Bates Diop and Jayshon Tate. And I'll give you the standard reminders here that our pool reporters for this site this round are Bruce Pascoe of the Arizona Daily Star and Adam Jardee of the Columbus Dispatch. Satellite coordinates Galaxy 17, transponder 17D, downlink frequency 12053.5H. And a reminder, please silence your cell phones in this area. If you have a question for student athletes, please raise your hand and I'll direct the microphone holders your direction. And we'll go ahead and start with questions for Ohio State student athletes.
NCAA tournament. So what's kind of the excitement level getting the program to Ohio State back into the dance?
We're excited because, like you said, you know, Ohio State programs used to being in the NCAA tournament. We've had a bad couple of years, but we're excited to be back.
Yeah, just like you said, you know, all the players come to Ohio State to, you know, play in March, and, you know, we had a couple of down years, but I couldn't ask for another a better senior year going out with this team in March.
Peter Huguenin with the Arbiter. Question for Bates Diop. What have you seen from Mike Dom so far, and what are your thoughts about matching up against him in the first game?
He's a very good player. You know, he's big and he can shoot the ball, and it makes him hard to guard. And we watched obviously a lot of their games and clips on him. He's a very tough matchup. A good player.
A question for both you guys again. I mean, you guys had a great season, but kind of didn't end it the way you want. I know you had three out of the last five lose and then lost in the Big Ten tournament. I mean, is there any concern going in? What's the mentality kind of going in, you know, into this NCAA tournament after kind of losing your last game?
Jayshon, let's start with you.
Just another opportunity to, you know, get this sour taste out of our mouth. You know, throughout the season, we've shown what it takes to win, and we've shown what happens when we don't do those things, we lose. So I think just our ability to, you know, focus on what got us to, you know, be number two in the Big Ten, finish off the regular season, and focus on that and just try to pay attention to coaching and scouting, and that's going to be the best thing we can do in this matchup against a very good team.
Keita?
Yeah, we were pretty good for most of the Big Ten. Obviously, we kind of fell off toward the end, but we still had a great, you know, Big Ten season, and, you know, we're capable of winning games and winning big games. So, we're trying to get that taste out of our mouths and just move forward.
Mark, right here.
Kind of going off that, both a question for both of you guys again. I mean, you guys are in the classic kind of 12-5 matchup. There's always been, you know, I think only four times in the history of the tournament, you know, has a 12 not upset of five. I mean, so what are you guys going to have to do to kind of avoid perhaps being upset by a South Dakota State team that's been to the dance three straight years in a row?
I'm just, you know, just prepare like we have in the past, you know, not try to get too caught up in, you know, how being nervous. We know this is a very good team, but as long as we listen to coach and we play for each other and stay together out there, I think we have a good chance to win the game.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, the numbers and all that, and the upsets happen all the time. We just don't want to be on the team that gets upset.
More questions for Ohio State student athletes? All right. We'll dismiss these two, and then we'll wait for Coach Holt.
Thank you, guys. I just had one quick one, if I could. John Patrick with KTIK Sports Radio here in Boise. Wondering what you guys knew about Boise before you found out that you were coming here to play in the tournament.
Not much. I knew you guys are known for, you know, here in Idaho for potatoes and pretty much just the blue field. Once I got off the plane, I was expecting to be a little colder, but it was actually much beautiful, way more beautiful than Ohio. I mean, last time, what was it, like 50, 60 yesterday?
It was actually pretty warm. I kind of like it.
Yeah, it was warm, and, you know, just the view of the, you know, the mountains and, you know, that's I didn't expect having that coming off the plane.
Any thoughts, Keita?
Yeah, I kind of like the mountains now that we don't have that in Ohio. So to see mountains coming off the plane was actually pretty nice.
Anything else? All right, thank you, guys. State coach Chris Holtman to the dais, and we'll go ahead and remind you that to ask a question, please raise your hand and indicate you have a question. I'll send a mic holder your direction. Now please silence your cell phones in this area, and let's go ahead and take questions for Coach Holtman.
Chris, you've had an unusually long break between the Big Ten tournament and going into tomorrow.
Yeah.
What have you done to try to stay sharp, and are there any benefits to having this break?
Well, we'll see. You know, I think that's the million-dollar question in a lot of ways. You know, I've gotten asked that, obviously, a lot. Excuse me. We'll see. I think it's a question that all the Big Ten teams are being asked and will eventually answer. We've tried to balance rest versus rust. You know, that can be difficult. We've also tried to make sure our guys are conditioned and ready to play. We've been banged up, and we were a little bit fatigued at the end of the year because we had some guys carry a pretty heavy load. So hopefully that rest helped. But, you know, we went off campus a few times. We scrimmaged, had an inter-squad scrimmage at another site. We changed up our practice times a little bit, had a meal together. And then as coaches, we got a lot of recruiting done.
Walt Nido, Press Tribune. You know, this is your first year, Coach. Just, you know, what was kind of your thoughts heading this season? Because Ohio State hadn't been to the dance in three seasons. So did you kind of feel some pressure kind of taking over a program that had missed out on the dance a few years?
Yeah, I mean, as a coach, you always feel, yeah, I think we all put tremendous pressure on ourselves. What we felt as a coaching staff, if in terms of pressure, was we wanted our upperclassmen, our seniors, to experience this tournament. It's a really unique thing that we're playing a team that's in its third straight NCAA tournament, and we only have three returning players that have played in an NCAA tournament game versus a team that's got quite a bit of experience. So I think more than anything, you just really wanted it for your older guys that haven't tasted this incredible tournament, maybe as much as we would have liked for them to. So if there was any pressure, that's what we felt. Obviously, we understood there were relatively low expectations for us early. Our guys answered the bell and put us in this position to do this, and you know, hopefully we can make the most of it.
Hello, Peter Huguenin from the Arbiter. Obviously, Bates Diop is a player that gets a lot of attention, but who else on the team could be an X factor for you guys in order to make a run?
Well, I think, you know, our sole focus is on tomorrow, not anything else. And I think that, you know, probably the guys that are always at the top of the scouting report for us are Bates Diop, as you mentioned, and Jayshon Tate. I think when we have played well and had success, our guards have played well for us. C.J. Jackson, Cam Williams, Andrew Dokic, those guys have played well for us. So they're going to need to. Listen, I think we're playing the best team that I've played in the opening round as a coach. So we're going to need those, you know, we're going to need a lot of good stuff from a lot of guys.
Coach, you guys obviously had a great season, but maybe didn't end it the way you wanted. I think you lost 3 out of 5 and then the exit of the Big Ten tournament to Penn State. I mean, just so what's the mentality of this team to maybe try to wash that away and maybe trying to start a new season here with this tournament to get back on track a little bit?
Yeah, I mean, I everybody has a loss or two at the end of the year. So you could look at a lot of college basketball and say that. I think we had a challenging closing schedule stretch. I don't think our guys were deterred by that by any stretch. You want to stay in this tournament as long as you can, and that's what we're trying to do. But I don't sense that they're fragile. I think they've got great respect for who we're playing, and we had a great closing win in the regular season, and obviously get bounced earlier in the tournament than we wanted to, the Big Ten tournament. But I think our guys are in a good place, and we know we'll need to play well.
Coach, just kind of going off that a little bit, you guys are in the kind of the classic 12-5 matchup. You know, there's only been four times, I think, in history where a 12 hasn't won. And, you know, I think you guys are maybe a popular pick to maybe, considering South Dakota's experience. So what are you guys going to have to do to maybe avoid that a little bit to get out of this first round and keep your season alive here?
I mean, I get it. I think that I understand why people are picking them a lot. They have a pro. They have great experience. They've got a really talented team. It's not just Dom. They have really talented guys around them, a terrific freshman guard. So I think people probably look at not only the 12-5 matchup and kind of historically what that's been, but they also look at the fact that those guys have great experience being in this thing. And when you have a pro on your roster, it makes a big difference. So I think we know we're going to need to be sharp. We're going to need to play well. We're going to need to be able to score the ball against their defense, and we're going to need to be able to make it difficult for them. They're a very gifted offensive team, and they play through their guys exceptionally well. They've got athleticism. They play really well together, really well. You can tell they're an experienced group because they play really, really well together. And, you know, listen, I think when you get into this thing, you realize that any team you play in this thing is good. But certainly when you get in kind of those middle-seeded games, you're playing a really talented team. And we certainly are.
More questions for Coach? All right. Thank
Ron,
you, Coach.
Paul. Ron.
Okay. All
right. We'll remind you that Dan Wallenberg and Brett Ryback will help you with Ohio State student athletes. Thank you.